Professor, yes, what are the main findings of your research?
There are two main results. The first one is that Cassini data are consistent with the existence of a large water reservoir underneath the icy surface of Enceladus. This water reservoir is located near the South Pole at a depth of about 30 to 40 kilometers, and it has a thickness of 8 to 10 kilometers. It should extend from the South Pole up to latitude of 50 degrees south, although our data cannot neither exclude nor confirm that this ocean is global. The second important result is that Enceladus is a differentiated body made up by two layers, an external icy layer of about 30-40 kilometer thickness, and an internal rocky core made up of silicates with a density of about 2.4 grams per cubic centimeters.
How do you get to the conclusion that there is a liquid ocean under the icy surface?
Well, we knew that water must exist under the surface of Enceladus because the southern polar region emits strong jets of water rich in salts. But we didn't know the extension and the geometry of this water pocket. We have been able to determine the location and the extension by comparing gravity with topography. The southern polar region is depressed. The depression is about 1 kilometer deep. So over the South Pole, there should exist a negative gravity anomaly. We have been able indeed to determine this negative gravity anomaly, which however is not as large as one would have expected from the missing mass. Therefore, we came to the conclusion that under the surface there must be a denser mass which partially compensates this anomaly. And this mass can come very naturally from water. Water is denser than ice, has a density about 7% larger than the one of ice, and can easily explain all the observations that we have been able to make.
What are the implications of your discovery?
Well, the main implication is that there are potentially habitable environments in the solar system in places which are completely unexpected. Enceladus has a surface temperature of about minus 180 degrees Celsius, but under that surface there exists liquid water. This water, in addition, is in contact with rocks, with silicates, and when water is in contact with silicates in presence of energy, there can exist a large variety of chemical reactions, a situation which is completely different from the one when you have water in contact with ice, which is a pretty boring situation.